Daytime baseball.
The second baseman, Nico Horner.
First pitch of the AB now. And that's high for a ball, 1-0. Dan Dero, these Brewers, as they begin play here this afternoon, they come in looking to turn things around as they've dropped two straight.
Hey, Matty, yeah, it's been a tough series so far, Dero. They've lost the first two. Two nail biters, two close games, low scoring games. They'd like to turn that fortune around here today.
Yeah, but from a manager's perspective, Dan, all you can ask for is effort, and that's what this team's given them. They took it on the chin, first two games, one run losses. They'll bounce back for it.
And there's one down now. And that'll bring in the Pittsburgh area native Ian Happ. He's ready for his first at-bat of his early season contest. He's set and the pitch. Good late break to the slider here, but he takes it in on the hands for ball one. Temperature about what you'd expect for this time of year, 56 degrees at first pitch. Chopper to short. Knee high, he barehands it. It's there, and he's out. Digging in next will be Chris Bryant. Couple of hits for him in four trips to the plate last night. First offering on its way.
The offensive game plan today is certainly to see the ball up. This guy is known on the mound for sinker changeup combination. He's going to try and establish down in the zone to get swing and a miss or ground balls consistently. You have to find something above the belt to get loose on.
Oh, and he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two.
Down 0-2, maybe simplify the game plan right here. Get on the heater, even though he has five weapons to go to.
Two out, nobody on. Out in front of that one, but he stays alive and will do it again on 0-2. He says, you got to be kidding me, with the side retired. Three up, three down for the Cubs. Cubs zero. Brewers coming to bat. You're watching Major League Baseball on the show. Jake Arrieta gets the starting nod for the Cubs in this one. What's your take on him, Dan?
Hey, this guy pitched really well in his last one to pick up a W in his last start when he got into the seventh inning. Let's see if he can make that two good, strong outings of seven-plus innings back-to-back.
In now is Lorenzo Cain. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. Here's the pitch.
Nope, that's down.
Dan Dero, the Cubs, as they take the field here this afternoon, have got to be considered one of, if not the hottest team in baseball right now, winners of eight of their last 10 ball games.
Yeah, Matty, I think if you would have asked the manager of this team, first five games of this road trip, you're going to go 4-1. He would have signed that in blood. So let the guys continue to play the way they've been playing. Everything is going nice right now.
Hit back up the middle, reined in. Throw to first is in time for the first down.
Batting second, the third baseman, Jago Robertson.
So next to bat will be Daniel Robertson. First delivery to him.
Eight.
The windup and the 0-1. Rips this one to first. A leaping try, but it's out of his reach and into the outfield. And he'll pull into second with one away.
And it looked like the pitcher was trying to get him to go fishing and a pitch out of the strike zone. He went for it all right, but he managed to catch all of that baseball, placing it for a double in the outfield. That's a great piece of hitting.
And here's Christian Yelich now as he lines it out to center. And that's in there. Base hit. And the runner from second will stay put at third. So they're runners at the corners now with one away.
That is good. The second baseman.
And that'll bring up Keston Hiura. As the first pitch sinker misses to him, it's ball one. And he's looking to get it going. Off to a bit of a slow start this year. Oh, and ouch. That one drilled him. And they'll end up taking the lead and talk about insult to injury. Hopefully he's okay. And time now to see quite where that got him. And it appeared from up here at least, and his actions on the field confirm it. It looked like it got him on his drive leg, which could be problematic, of course, for him. But from the way he's trying to walk it off, I think he's going to try to continue. Dan Vogelbach is next. Yes, he'll take a tough pitch on the outside part of the plate for strike one.
Tough situation early out on the mound, but if he can limit the damage right here, might build some confidence and get him rolling.
Ready with the nothing and one pitch. Hit hard on the ground towards second, and that's through into center field. Base hit, and the run will score from second to make this a 2-0 ball game. And they are just teeing off on him right now, and even in just the first inning, you've got to wonder how much longer they'll let him continue out there. So here's Avisaíl Garcia as he'll take a look at ball one. Another first inning RBI opportunity for him here. Here comes the pitch for Garcia. Right side, but it's going to be a foul ball. Runners are at first and third, one away. Easy take there on the sinker, well off the outside.
Great chance right here as a hitter to be really aggressive. With two guys already on, pretty good shot. He's going to get a challenge pitch right here.
The 2-1. Off on the breaking ball, so the count runs full.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Now the payoff pitch home. Making him sweat out there. The seventh pitch coming up. Good bite to that sinker as he gets him to swing through it for route number two.
One thing to know is not all strikeouts are created equal. Right there, he goes down on strikes, but he really made that guy on the mound work for it. And when you're doing that in the first inning, it can have an effect on how deep he's going to be able to go into this start. There's a big difference between that and going down on three or four pitches.
At the plate now, Narvaez, as the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. And they're runners at the corners now. Turned on that one and crushed it, just pulled it a little foul. Runners at the corners, two men out. Oh, my. This ball is crushed. Where will this one end up? Gone. And that one has some extra distance. So a three-run shot to right center field. Second home run early in the year. And the Brewers have made this a 5-0 ball game.
What a way to start this one off. Scoreless top of the frame, and you answer with a bomb in the bottom of the first.
Next to bat, Orlando Arcia. And a swing from him yields a foul pop out of play to the right. He's the eighth man to bat here in the first with five runs already up on the scoreboard. And it's one and one. Up the middle. There's Baez. Throw in time, and they stop the bleeding as this side is retired. But not before five crossed the plate, with the big blow being this three-run home run. We'll head to the top of the second. It's the Brewers five and the Cubs nothing. And that'll bring Anthony Rizzo to the plate. He's ready for his first at-bat of this early season contest.
They've gotten a gut punch to start this game. There's no doubt about this, but that's when you have to turn the scoreboards off. Everybody do their job one at-bat at a time.
Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch.
Off the plate, ball one.
Well, today's game provides the visiting squad with a chance to complete the series sweep, guys.
Sure does, and it's always difficult to sweep and win a series on the road, especially when you're playing a division opponent.
Now the 1-0 is a ball down and away. So let's take a peek at our umpiring crew in this one. Behind the plate is Gary Simmons.
Dero, this Gary Simmons, he's the kind of umpire that pitchers really like to throw to.
Yeah, I'm okay with it, though, Dan. You want to go east-west, I'll make the adjustment. It's the north-south that'll kill you.
2-0 count and the pitch. Javier Baez will be next. swing and a ball hit on the ground.
Hey, that's a good sinker right there. That's his bread and butter pitch, and if he's got that going, especially early, it's going to be tough to get some runs off him.
Now the payoff pitch home. Chopper to short. Arcia fields it cleanly. Throw is in time for the first out of the second.
That is it. The shortstop, Javier Baez.
And now, Javier Baez, lifetime against this particular arm. He's only 1 for 10. He's also been a strikeout victim 6 times. Now here's the first offering.
No, this one.
Good slider there, gets a swing and miss. Now, of course, it's still rather early, but there is a bit of a hill for them to climb if they're going to complete this sweep. They trail by a considerable margin to this point.
It's a kind of an easy thing to do when you're trying to sweep a team. You fall behind early. There's a lot of baseball still left, but they're going to have to score some runs and score some in a hurry to get back into this one.
The 1-2. Is a wave and a miss. He struck him out.
This pitching staff has done a really good job against this guy in this series. This is a really good hitter, and it's not easy to make a guy strike out 5 times in a series up to this point, but that's what they've done to this guy so far.
Next to hit will be Wilson Contreras, as he'll go after the first pitch and bounce it into foul territory. He'll work on keeping this top of the second alive. The 0-1 on its way. Bases are empty here with 2 men out. Little chopper back to the mound. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. Cubs are down in order. Need to get it going soon. It's 5-0. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and in to hit next will be Corbin Burns.
The pitcher.
Here's the first pitch to him.
Ball one. Ball one, no strike.
From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Sinker misses that time, and it's 2-1.
There's the heavy sinker right there. What makes that pitch so difficult to hit is not only does it change eye levels, it actually changes plane. You go to hit it at one position, and it's 6 to 8 inches dropping off the table and chasing your hands.
The 3-1 takes a strike for a full count now, 3-2.
88 on a changeup. I remember when an 88 mile an hour fastball wasn't all that bad. Man, the game's changing.
Sent on the ground out to second. He's got it, and the throw to first is in time. One gone.
Up next to the ball.
No one on with one down, and that'll bring up Lorenzo Cain.
Yeah.
Here's the first pitch.
Count 1-0.
Strike taken as that one catches the outer part of the plate. And he takes ball two, and it's 2-1.
Big sweeping breaking ball right there. Good pitch. But if he wants to get him to swing at it, he'll have to bring it in a little bit closer to the strike zone.
The 2-1 home. Sinker misses there, and now he's in trouble. 3-1.
I'm sure he's frustrated by that call. Probably could have been a strike, but at the same time, earning strikes from the umpire is a real thing. If you've been all over the place like he has, you're just not going to get much help from the umpires.
The 3-1. Into right field. That's a base hit.
Wow, and the hits just keep piling up for them. Take a look at the numbers here. That's already six hits, and we're only in the second inning. We'll see if they can keep this up as the innings go on.
Standing in now, Daniel Robertson, as he'll look at a changeup that drops below the knees for ball one. It was a double for him in his first turn at the plate. A ball and a strike. Kane, base runner at first with one out. Looked like he was on that one, but it's 1-2. Well below the knees, laid off on the changeup there.
You can really tell about how effective this guy's going to be when guys are swinging at that changeup. So far in this one, they've been real smart to let it go.
Even at two balls and two strikes, here's the pitch. High and deep down the left field line. The 2-2 one more time. Popped him up. Fires over to his right. Makes the play, and there are two gone now. Now it'll be Christian Yelich, who collected a base hit his first time up. From the stretch, here's the pitch. As he'll watch one miss down and in for a ball, 1-0. Using the slide step to try to control the running game.
Yeah, that's a good way of trying to control the running game, Matt. The problem with it, though, it has a tendency to throw your command off because you're worrying about that runner on base.
Ground ball sent back up the middle. Throw cleanly into first, and that ends the inning. Milwaukee leaves one, but they hold a 5-0 lead.
I'm wearing a cape and apron, so I ain't saving you a cleaning house. Do you think that's just a statement? And you're ludicrous like it's word of mouth. I ain't new to what I'm about.
Here's Jake Mariznick. He's the number 7 hitter, but he's leading off the third after the first 6 guys in the lineup have been retired in order.
Yeah, it's been a great start to the guy on the mound. It'll be interesting to see if they can find a way to get to this guy before he really settles in.
Now the pitch. Third inning starts with a slider that's looked at here for ball one.
I love everything this pitcher's got working right now. He's got presence. He's got great body language on the mound. He's got fastball command and a nice early feel for his off-speed stuff.
And a strike to even the count. 1-1. And the pitch. Swing and a foul tip, but that's held onto behind the plate. It's a strikeout for out number one.
Well, there's the great equalizer, the changeup, El Cambio. Listen, if you can keep that pitch in your back pocket and pull it out when you need it, like he did right there, usually hitters, they don't stand a chance.
Here's Jason Hayward now. As the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. And he's looking to get it going. Off to a bit of a slow start this year. He's set. Here's the 0-1. Pops this one up. Mogulbag is camped under this one. And he's got it for out number two. So two are gone now in the Cubs' half of the third, and that'll bring up the pitcher, Jake Arrieta. Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch as he comes up empty on a pitch right down the middle for strike one. The 0-1 pitch. That's taken. Now it's 0-2.
You know that nasty changeup's lurking right here. If I'm in the batter's box, I have to tell myself to stay back. I have to take pull side out of the equation, or that changeup's going to beat me.
A swing and a miss as he chased with two strikes, and that will retire the side. Three up, three down for the Cubs. They can't chip into that 5-0 deficit. Bottom of the inning now, and in at the plate steps Keston Hiura. Ready. Here's the first pitch. Here's a little chopper up the middle. And he'll reach first as they can't make the play on him.
Nice effort by the shortstop right there. Kept it in front of him. That's all he could do right there, Dan. You know, deal on a spot like that. That's an infield single. That's a tough play. Just to knock that ball down was a pretty good job. But any way you look at it, that should be scored a base hit, and I'm sure it was.
Stepping in now, Daniel Vogelbach, as the changeup to him drops in there for the first strike. 1-for-1 with a single so far. Just a bit late, and he's fallen behind 0-2. Hiura aboard here at first with nobody out. Fouled away. And a changeup swung on and missed for the first down.
Well, that's just a quality pitch right there. The location was excellent because if it's put in play, there's a good chance it's on the ground for a double play. And, hey, a strikeout always works too.
So here is Abisayo Garcia as it's grounded sharply to first. There's one on to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. One hit's all they get. On now to the top of inning number four. Brewers lead it 5-0. In now is Nico Hoerner back to the top of the lineup as they're still looking for their first base runner in this one.
No doubt about that, Matt. They've yet to figure this guy out on the mound. He's looked great so far.
He has, but we'll see if this second trip through the order changes anything.
Yeah, it'll be interesting to see what kind of adjustments these hitters are able to make in the middle innings of this game.
Here it comes. Too high that time with the inning's first pitch. It's ball one.
Yeah, that looked like a strike, but let me tell you, when you're staring at a big zero in the hit column, getting a call like that to go your way can feel like a big victory.
The 1-0 home. Loud contact there, but it's well foul. Fouls this one off. Here comes the 1-2. He is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
Classic slider down and away for the strikeout there. Not a whole lot to say about that pitch that hasn't been said a million times already. That's just a real tough pitch for a hitter to pick up out of a pitcher's hand, so they end up chasing when they're in protect mode.
Into the box now, Ian Happ. Swung on but fouled off to the left. 0-for-1 for him here in this one.
One and one.
Happ is a big threat in a matchup like this. He's got a ton of pop against right-handed pitching.
Yeah, I think because of his approach. He's not a dead pull guy. You want to try and sneak a piece of cheese in or hang something over the heart of the plate, he's going to absolutely crush it. But anything going away from him goes right into
count
his bat pad.
Count is 1-2 now. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone.
Pretty impressive back-to-back strikeouts to start the inning. What's even more important is now he gets to face the middle of the order without anybody on base for them to drive in.
Here's Chris Bryant now. As he'll swing and lift a fly ball to right center. Garcia is underneath this one, and he will put it away to retire the side. Cubs are down in order. Need to get it going soon. It's 5-0. Just about set to go for the last of the fourth. But before we do that, here's Heidi Watney.
Well, Matt, during the break, I caught up with Craig Counsell, the Brewers skipper, about his lineup's performance so far. And he's really pleased with how they've performed in run-scoring opportunities in this one. He said he's seen his hitters take it to another level with runners in scoring position today, which is reflected in their batting average in those situations. Over a 600 clip. Clearly, that's been a big part of the story of this game.
Good stuff, Heidi. Thanks. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth. And now it'll be the catcher, Narvaez. Here's the first pitch. He grounds it sharply to third. Throw on to first in time, one away. Now one down with the bases empty. And up next will be the shortstop, Orlando Arcia. First pitch of the AB now. Ball one as he lays off below the zone. And a change up here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball. From the windup, the 2-0 pitch. Weak roller right side. Throw to first will get him. Already two away here in the home fourth. So here now is the pitcher, Corbin Burns, comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ballgame. Harriet is ready. Here comes the first pitch. And a good pitch on the inside corner for strike one.
One of the big keys to pitching well is getting ahead early on, and it's been far from that for this guy so far. Less than 50% of his first pitches have been for strikes.
No ball, a swinging strike, and now it's 0-2.
Hey, you think back to the early innings right there, you thought this guy would have been hitting his showers. A credit to him. He's been able to regroup, find his mechanics, and find a way to stay in this game.
Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. Three up, three down for Milwaukee as they're unable to add to their 5-0 lead. Welcome back. Heidi Watney standing by as we get set for the top of the fifth.
Thanks, Matt. In between innings, I was able to catch up with the manager of the Cubs to discuss his thoughts on his lineup so far, and he was pretty blunt in saying they're just not having very good at-bats. They haven't had a single guy on base yet, so it's starting to feel a little desperate down here. But he said they've unfortunately just been faced with some really great pitching today. The key going forward is to find any way they can to get him out of his rhythm on the mound. Now, that may be a tall task, but they feel the little adjustments could lead to things turning around for them.
Thank you, Heidi. Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch. Anthony Rizzo is at the plate here as he quickly finds himself down a strike. It's 0-1. Now, pitch on the way.
This guy's been really on point so far, but it's not getting any easier. He has to get through 4, 5, and 6 right here.
On its way, the 0-2 pitch. Too high. 1-2. Pitch on the way. As anticipated, here's a ground ball now to the right side. And he'll step on first himself for the out. Into the box, Javier Baez. He's 0-for-1 thus far. I'm set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. A ball and no strikes. Now the 1-0. Sent in the air out to straightaway center. Keane is there now, and he has it. Two gone.
The catcher.
So the bases are empty here with two gone, and Wilson Contreras digs in at the plate. Ready to deal. Here comes the first pitch. And that's cut on and missed, 0-1. Cubs to this point have yet to break into the hit column. Not close with the off-speed pitch taken for a ball.
You know he's probably cheating on that inside pitch after he got jammed earlier. If you're on the mound right now, you want to try to hit that outside corner, and there's a pretty good chance you'll get him to roll over something.
Sinker on the inside, and that's a strike.
Man, he's in control of all his weapons right here. One strike away from five shutout innings.
Here's the 1-2 delivery. Ball two with a sinker that runs off the inside. Here now the 2-2. Struck him out, his seventh of the ball game, and that ends the inning. Three up, three down for the Cubs. They can't chip into that 5-0 deficit. And in to hit next is Lorenzo Cain as we move past the halfway point in this one and begin the bottom of the fifth. First pitch coming. Here it is. Here's a breaking ball, but it doesn't quite find the strike zone. Swung on and missed. 1-1. Hard hit ball to second, but this will be taken in at second base. Good positioning for the first down.
The batter, the third baseman, Jacko.
At the plate now is Daniel Robertson, 1-for-2 with a double on the ledger so far. First pitch of the AB now. And that misses for ball one.
After watching that one go by and a ball being called, you could rest assured he knows he's not getting away with another one of those. I guarantee you he's going to be aggressive on this next pitch.
Now the 1-0. Fouled off. Bases are empty, one man out. Oh, had him off stride that time, and it's 1-2.
Woo, that was an ugly swing. If I'm pitching right now, I'm throwing that same pitch again. That was ugly.
The 1-2.
There's a pitch we haven't seen in a while. It's going to be tough on the hitters if they have to incorporate that into their mindset.
Here's another 1-2. Five runs, seven hits, and no errors on the Milwaukee line score so far. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Hayward has a read on it, and he makes the catch for the second out. Now at the plate, Christian Yelich. One for two. He's singled and grounded out so far. First pitch on its way. Two out, nobody on. That evens it up, one and one. Two and one. And this is on the inside edge, perhaps off the inside edge, but it's a called strike. Two and two now. Not surprisingly here, this is on the ground to the right side. Throw to first beats him easily, and the side is retired. So they're held in check here this half of the inning. We're through five here at the ballpark. It's the Brewers five, and the Cubs nothing. Now into the box, Jake Marisnik. He went down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Yeah, but it was a good changeup, Matty. Good arm action on that pitch. Look for him to try and stay back a little bit more. Let the ball get a little deeper. Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to rush a heater right here.
First delivery to him. The 1-0 home. Hit out towards second. He'll get to this one deep in the hole. Throw to first gets him, so the leadoff man's retired here to begin the sixth.
When the guy in the mound is working on a no-no this late, every play is exciting and stressful for the fielders. We'll see if they can continue making the plays behind him.
So that'll bring up Jason Hayward. He popped out in his first trip. Set, here it comes. Set to deliver the 0-1.
No, that's down.
Hayward, or often just Jay Hay. He was selected in the first round back in the draft of 2007.
Yeah, he has turned himself into a really nice ball player. I wouldn't put him on the superstar level, but you know what? They didn't miss with this pick either. You go into high rounds and you carve out a career the way this guy has, nice pick.
And he popped him up, and this is going to wind up a foul ball. The 1-2. One out, nobody on. Turned on down the line. A dive, but it's off his glove. Throw gets him, two down. Striding in is Jake Arrieta, struck out in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, and he didn't put up much of a fight either, Matty. Gotta find a way. Can't go down three pitches. I don't care if you're staring at him or swinging at him. You have to find a way to make this pitcher work a little bit harder.
First offering. And now a pitch on the way. And he takes a cold strike up and out over the plate. 0-2.
You got to go into battle mode after falling down 0-2 and find a way to work yourself back to even.
And he struck him out. So it might be time to begin the countdown as he's now gone through six innings without allowing a base hit. They certainly know how to have a good time in Milwaukee. And I believe this may just be a brand new type of polka. More matinee baseball here on a Wednesday afternoon following this. Bottom of the sixth inning now, and next will be the imposing power bat, Keston Hiura. First offering.
Outside, that's a ball.
Here it comes, 1-0. This one's down to third. Bryant is up with it, and that's out number one. And with one away, let's give you a look at the standings in the NL Central entering play as you see where these two teams sit in relation to one another. So the next to bat will be Daniel Vogelbach, 1-for-2 on his line so far in the game. First offering on its way. Bases are empty, one man out. Here's a curveball in the dirt that time for a ball. 1-1. Swung on, and this ball is absolutely crushed. Forget about it. And it's gone as they add still another. Solo shot to right center. Home run number 3 here in the early going. As they pile on, it's now 6-0.
Wow. You want to know how strong this guy is? That was a changeup, and he drives it to straight center. Dead center out of the ballpark. He makes it look easy, doesn't he?
Now,
Avisail Garcia.
As the sinker to him finds the zone for strike one. No hits to this point. High and deep down the left field line. Here comes the pitch for Garcia. That's popped up. Hayward coming on, but he can't make the play as it finds the outfield grass.
Hey, just a nice piece of hitting right there. He's able to keep his hands inside that ball, stay square as long as possible, and feed it into the opposite field for a base hit.
So now to the plate, Narvaez, as he'll try and hold off the swing, but this one's in there for strike one. He's 1-for-2 in this one. He's ready. Here's the 0-1. Here's a weakly hit fly ball off to the left side. In there, a base hit.
He's getting a visit from the pitching coach, but I think it's a little too late for him to turn things around. I mean, he's given up 6 runs, so I'm not sure how much the talking is going to help. He just doesn't have it today.
plate now, Orlando Arcia, as he'll swing and miss at a first pitch slider at strike one. He's 0 for 2 in the ballgame so far. Off the plate and in, it's a ball and a strike.
Lots of hits given up, but so far no walks. At least he's making them work to get on base. Problem is, they haven't had to work too hard.
Garcia over at second. Nevarez at first, one gone. Grounded to third. This could be two. Bryant's got it. The second for one. On to Rizzo, and it's a double play. Side retired. One scores in the inning coming on this solo home run. Top of the order due up to start the seventh. It's the Brewers six and the Cubs nothing. Seventh inning ready to roll, and up next, Nico Horner.
The second baseman, Nico Horner.
Wheels and deals, here's the first pitch. Swing here as he wanted to pull it back, but he does so too late. It's strike one. Now the 1-1 pitch. Hit on the ground to third. Ah, way to get dirty. Hey now.
That ball almost got through the hole right there. Could have been a seeing eye single. Love to step in a dive to his left. That's actually a harder play. It's almost easier to go backhand when you're reacting at third base. Nice play right there. Nice angle to the baseball.
In now, Ian Happ. As he'll take a breaking ball too low, and it's 1-0. 0 for 2 for him to this point.
Opinion, one of the toughest pitches in the game to square up. Just a heavy sinker with good downward action.
The 1-1 home is looked at for ball number two. A little early, and now it's even at 2-2.
You can really tell they're trying to keep the ball in on this big slugger right here.
Is that an effort to keep him from getting extended, do you think?
Yeah, I think that's the idea, Matt. But he might spin to win if he starts looking for it in there.
Hot shot down the line. And that's a base hit. So the perfect game bid ends in the seventh. Not in time, and he's in there with a double. Ah, they finally break through for their first hit of the ball game. So the no-hit bid will end right here.
Yeah, Matty V, and this is when you start thinking about that no-no. You get into the seventh inning, D-Row. As a pitcher, you start looking ahead to what might happen.
And that donut stares at you from an offensive standpoint as well.
This guy's had his A game. You can't deny the fact that he's pitched a heck of a game, but from an offensive standpoint, you never stop grinding to get a crooked number up on that board.
As he'll take a look at a high strike that time, it's nothing and one. The 0-1 on its way.
Your idea of working the count goes out the window. You're frustrated right now, down 0-2. Gotta find a way to grind.
A ball and two strikes. Here comes the 1-2.
Regardless of the result right here, to be down 0-2 and work it back to an even count, gotta feel like it's a win for the offense.
Cutter, and it doesn't make it back. 3-2.
Wow, this is a pretty good at bat right here. From down in the count 0-2 to work the count back to 3-2. And he's seen a lot of pitches, too.
Now the payoff pitch home. And that misses ball four. So it's first and second now with only one away.
This is only their second base runner of the game after that earlier hit. Tough to score when you don't have anyone on base. So we'll see if they can get something going here.
So now here is Anthony Rizzo. No hits in two trips to the plate for him in the ball game. Now the first pitch. Sinker to open the AB in there for strike one. Some action out in the bullpen. Couple of right-handers starting to loosen up. A little quick on that swing, and he finds himself behind 0-2. Nothing in two count, and the pitch. Inside and high with that one. One ball, two strikes. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. Two balls and two strikes to Rizzo. Rolled slowly down the third baseline, but a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. From the belt, the pitch. A great pitch there as he couldn't get extended on that one, and he's down on strikes for the second out.
That has to make you feel really good as a pitcher, right? You're making pitches all around the zone, and then you bring that one inside. You can't do anything with it. What does it do? It just locks you up inside. You have no chance to put the ball in play.
Next, here is Javier Baez. Two outs and two runners aboard here in the seventh inning. Ready to deliver. Here comes the first pitch. A fastball taken for strike one. The 0-1 on its way. Good pitch there. Had him a little out in front. As a look, now the pitch. And he will strike him out. 10 now in the ballgame, and the inning is over. Back-to-back strikeouts keep him out of danger. More matinee baseball here on a Wednesday afternoon following this. Colton Wong is up off the bench as he'll be asked to get something started in the home half of the seventh. ready. Here's the first pitch. Long, once a member of the Cardinals organization, he signed as a free agent with this organization earlier in the season.
Yeah, he didn't have an opportunity to really get acclimated to this ball club. Showing up during the season is not always easy, opening the doors to a big league clubhouse and trying to get to know your teammates. The best way to get to know them is to go out and produce.
And the pinch hitter is retired here, one away. One away for the Brewers in their half of the seventh. And that'll bring up the center fielder, Lorenzo Cain. First pitch on the way.
Ball, that's out.
One out, nobody on. A one and one count to the Brewers leadoff man.
One ball, one strike.
Tries to change up on him there, but it's a ball, two and one. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. And a full count to Cain, three balls and two strikes. This one's flared off to the right side. Horner backs up and takes care of it. Two away. And now here is Daniel Robertson.
Daniel Robertson.
Arrieta's got his target. Here comes the first pitch. Here's a sinker to start him out, but he wouldn't bite. It's ball one. Now here's one hit in the air to the right side, and this is going to wind up a foul ball. Bases are empty here with two men out. Lined in to right, a base hit.
Boy, you see that happen quite a bit at the big league level, D-Roll. Breaking ball up and away, a hit for a bullet for a base hit.
Yeah, Dan, you try and look for it to pop out above the pitcher's hand. That usually signifies that it's going to be something breaking. That was actually a slider, so nice job by the offensive player, not only recognizing it, but not trying to do too much.
First pitch of the AB now. Strike one to start the at bat.
Hey, a two out single isn't all that bad, but it can be when you've got this part of the lineup coming up.
Grounded back up the middle. And that's through for a hit. Happ scoops it up. The relay, the tag, and they'll get him at second. And with that, the side is retired. Brewers strand one. They lead it 6-0. Justin Topa has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 56.
New inning set to get underway, and stepping up to hit next, the catcher Wilson Contreras. First pitch on its way. And he misses inside with that one. Ball one. High strike there. It's 1-1.
Yeah, guys, he's got so much respect for this guy's fastball, you could tell he was out in front on that slider. I think he goes to the well one more time with that pitch.
2-2 to the Cubs catcher. A swing and a miss on the ball way out of the zone, and there's one away. Final line there for the Brewers starting pitcher. Great day's work any way you look at it.
Hey, Matty, this guy had it going in this one. You look down at the bottom of that scroll. 10 strikeouts. He hit that swing and miss stuff from the beginning all the way to the end in this one.
Standing in now, Jake Marisnik. As he'll go after the first pitch to him and comes up empty, it's strike one. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Action now in the Milwaukee bullpen as they'll have a right-hander loosen up. Smoke toward the hole, and this will get through into right, and he's aboard with a single.
Battle the right fielder, Jason Hayward.
Into the box, Jason Hayward. As he'll take a look at a slider here that misses for ball one. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. Marisnik stands at first with one out. A little behind on that swing, and now he'll try to shorten up maybe and protect the plate. The 1-2 pitch.
No, that's cold.
Could see the runner in motion here on a 3-2 count with one out. There's a pretty good chance he's going to get a pitch to swing at, and if not, it's ball four anyways.
Now the payoff pitch home. High in the air down the right field line. On the move is Garcia. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out. And now in the box, Jake Arrieta. He struck out swinging in his last trip to the plate.
Yeah, Matty, big time K last time up, and it's been a tough series for him so far. You can tell he's just not seeing the ball off this team. Let's see if he can make an adjustment right here.
A ball and no strikes. The 1-0 hit to first, scooped up, and he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Cubs strand one. They won't make a dent in a 6-0 deficit. Bottom of inning number eight set to go, and that'll bring in the second baseman, Keston Hiura. Here's the first pitch. Cubs have someone working in their bullpen now as a right-hander's begun to get loose. Hit on the ground out to short. And there's one away. So here is Daniel Vogelbach. He homered earlier and is 2-for-3 to this point.
And that was a great swing he put on that changeup last time up to hit that home run. Just an absolutely textbook job of letting it travel, keeping his hands back before exploding on it.
Pulls the string on that one, one strike. The Cubs came into this one riding pretty high, presented with the opportunity to sweep the series. However, it has clearly not gone the way they'd hoped.
One of the things you have to do is play 27 outs and not give any at-bats away. They're down by several runs here. It doesn't look good, but they still have a chance. And when you have a chance, you have hope.
Pitch taken several inches below the zone, in fact. And for the opposition, finishing this one off and salvaging a win in the series will sort of allow them to at least save a little face here at home.
No doubt about it. The last thing you want to do is get beat around in your own backyard. You want to make your home ballpark a winning ballpark. So winning this one and avoiding the sweep could be just what the doctor ordered.
Here's the pitch on 2-2. And that misses, so it's a full count, 3-2.
And it's late in his afternoon of work, and the longer this at bat goes, the better chance of him making a mistake. But as a guy starts to tire, they're more likely to leave the ball up. But man, he's been good so far.
Now the payoff pitch home. Hit down the line at first. And this will get foul, so they'll do it again, 3-2. Keeps fighting him off. The eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. And he can only battle for so long as he's finally set down here after an eight-pitch at-bat.
When you're this deep into a start, it can be really exhausting and annoying when a hitter makes you work as hard as he did right there. He got the strikeout. That's great, but he's probably thinking, get that guy out of here.
Plate now, Avisail Garcia. This will come up empty that time on a sinker at strike one. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. Arrieta's got his target. Here he comes, 0-1. A swing and a ground ball to third. And a sliding try there at third, but it skips by him, a base hit.
In this case, the numbers really do say it all. That's an incredible 13 hits now. Nothing pretty about those numbers. Kind of amazing he's even still in this one.
Mm-hmm. stepping in now. Narvaez, as the first pitch to him, runs a bit inside for ball one. So far, 2-for-3 in this one. Manager up out of the dugout now, as he'll make the slow walk to the mound. And he's going to motion for the bullpen, as that'll be all for his starter this afternoon. So he'll leave here trailing and was not all that sharp in his 7 2/3. A runner on first with two away. And a fastball here that's taken for ball two.
Those were great takes right there. Those were pitches that a lot of guys normally swing at, but he took both of them and finds himself in a productive count leverage. 2-0.
And it's fouled away. Now the 2-1 pitch is swung on and missed, and that's strike two.
Two strikes.
Still 2-2. Two out with the man at first. Look out. Don't want to hit him there. It's full 3-2.
3-2, two out, runner on first. Lots of possible outcomes on this pitch.
And the payoff pitch. And he misses ball four. So he comes out of the bullpen and immediately walks the first man he faces.
The batter, number three, shortstop, Orlando.
Now to bat, Orlando Arcia. He was a double play victim last time around.
Yeah, rolling into a two ball will eat at you for the rest of the game at least. So you know he wants to make up for it right here.
From the stretch.
Nope. Ball one. Ball one, no strike.
The 1-0 home.
Nope.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
Here he comes on 2-0. Down low, and the plot thickens here, 3-0.
Well, nothing can make you question yourself on that mound more than three straight balls to a guy you know that you should go right after. Sometimes you just lose the strike zone and you don't know why.
Three balls, one strike to Orlando Arcia.
3-1 with 2-1, and this is where you got to be geared up for something to drive. I don't think you can just groove it one right here. You still have to try to make a competitive pitch.
Looking to wiggle out of this. Here it is. Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike. Payoff pitch home. Hit hard on the ground towards second. Fielded cleanly. On to first, and the Brewers are turned away as the inning is over. Good work that time from the Chicago pen. Ninth inning coming up. It's the Brewers 6 and the Cubs nothing. Now we're going to have a conference at the home plate area, so it would appear that we'll see a double switch here. Devin Williams will come on now, and he'll slide into the seventh spot in the lineup following the double switch. Manny Pena is into the ballgame as well, as he'll slide into the pitcher's spot, hitting ninth now on the double switch. All set to start the ninth in this one, and up next, Nico Horner. Now the first pitch.
We're going to see him throw that hard fastball early and often.
One ball and one strike to the Cubs leadoff batter. The 1-1. Three balls and a strike to the Chicago leadoff hitter. Ian Happ is on deck. And it's up to a 3-2 full count now. Swing and a shot back up the middle. And that'll make him 1-for-4 in this one. With that, the Cubs get their leadoff man aboard.
You know, D-Ro, there's been some great pitching in this one so far. After that knock, that's only the third hit of the game, and we're getting late into this one.
Yeah, they always say you got to tip your hat to the opposition sometimes. Well, I think this offense is tired of tipping its hat. They got to start to swing the bats a little bit better. That's their third knock of the game. I know it's late, but maybe they can get something going.
At the plate, Ian Happ. Back up the middle. And there's a base hit as well, as that's into center field. Two straight hits to kick off the ninth. Fortunately for him, though, no error on the bobble, and the runners will hold at first and second now.
Hey, this might be their best opportunity to at least get on the board. They've been struggling offensively, and they find themselves with two runners on board. Let's see if they can continue it.
Stepping in once again is Chris Bryant. And these guys are making a little push here. You have to like the effort despite the odds.
Yeah, you really do, Matt. Look, they still have a significant hill to climb. But, hey, they string a couple of hits together here, and all of a sudden this thing feels doable.
First delivery to him as he looks at a fastball that misses off the plate for ball one. Horner on second, half at first with no outs. And 2-0 as this one's taken low.
Got to find a way to execute either a good fastball down and away or flip something off speed for a strike. You cannot miss over the heart of the plate in these situations. The hitter is on high alert.
Now a good pitch around the knees, but it doesn't quite catch the bottom of the zone. Waiting next is Anthony Rizzo. Now the 3-0 offering. Is in there for strike one. Swing, strike two.
That's not a pitch he misses very often.
He knows he should have done something with that one.
First and second here with nobody out. Fouled away. Little tardy on that swing as it's well wide of first. This is swung on and missed, and boy, they took care of a key man there. One away.
It's been a really rough day for this lineup. There's really no other way to say it. Not a lot of good scoring opportunities, and when they've had them, like right now, it's just been an uphill battle for them to make anything positive happen.
Anthony Rizzo stands in now as he will look at a first pitch fastball for ball one. He could really use a knock here, 0 for 3 in the game so far. To the left and foul. One ball, one strike. First and second now, one man out. Up and in here as he had to bend out of danger.
I don't know if there was any intent behind that pitch, but it certainly opens up the outer half of the plate with this next one.
And it's two balls and two strikes now.
He's certainly pushing the throttle and pulling it with those four pitches. Statistics class tells me I'm sitting fast.
Two balls and two strikes to Rizzo. Swing and a miss on the fastball that time, out number two. Got him with a good high fastball there. Danny, we see a lot of that pitch in strikeout situations these days. What makes it so effective?
I think, Matt, what makes it such a tough pitch is you're changing eye levels. That fastball up looks so enticing to hit that you think you see that ball as a hitter. You think you can drive it, but it's really hard to get on top of that good, high, hard fastball.
Here's the first pitch as he'll look at a fastball too high for ball one.
Hey, this pitcher's going to have to step off the mound right here and refocus. Take a deep breath, something. Can't keep falling behind and creating traffic. It puts everybody on edge, not only himself, his defense, and especially his manager.
2-0.
He's got a couple of pitches to deal with right here, but he's starting to lose command of his pitches. It might be time to take a step back and try to refocus and making some good pitches.
Two and one after the foul ball there. Comes set. Now the pitch.
Might have been taking all the way right there. That pitch couldn't have split the strike zone any better. And you can bet he wants that one back at the plate.
Cubs are down to their final strike here. Hit to third. Throw on to second for the force, and the ball game is over.
Well, the tone was set for this game from the very first inning. They came out absolutely banging the ball around and took that great start to another notch in the win column.
6-0, the final shutout score today. The Milwaukee Brewers came out swinging with a huge first inning that really set them up well. Corbin Burns notches his third win of the year as he finishes seven innings, allowing only one hit. Jake Arrieta permitted six earned runs to come across in the losing effort. So that'll do it for us. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to the new website, theshow.com.